dear Danny, I'm taking the pen in me hand to tell you we're just out of sight of the land. In a big anchor liner, we're sailing in style, and we're sailing away from the Emerald Isle. A strange sort of sigh seems to come from us all as the waves hit the last bit of old Donegal. Sure, it's good to be you that is taking your tay, where they're cutting the corn around Creeslough the day. Sure, I spoke to the captain and he won't turn around, and if I swam back I'd be up to the drown. So I'll stay where I am, for the diet is great, and there's lots of combustibles piled on my plate. Although it is sumptuous, should I swap the whole lot for the old wooden spoon in the stirabout pot? And Katie Fornenst be a-wettin the tay, where they're cutting the corn around Creeslough the day. There's a woman on board that knows Katie by sight, and we talked of old times till they put out the light. I'm to meet the good woman tomorrow on deck, and we'll talk about Katie from here to Quebec. Sure, I know I'm no match for her, no, not the least, with her house and two cows and her brother a priest. But the woman declares Kitty's heart's on the say, while mine's with the reapers round Creeslough the day. Ah, goodbye to you, Danny, there's no more to be said, but I think the salt water's got into my head, and it drips from my eyes when I call to my mind the friends and the kindlings I'm leaving behind. And sure, Katie herself, when she bade me goodbye, had just a slight trace of a tear in her eye, and a break in her voice when she said you might stay, but please God I'll come back to Creeslough someday.